we good?
You good? Hello? Hello?
And welcome to the 2017 Senior Division Championship of the West Hartford Youth Basketball League. My name is Joe Gamo, and I'm here with Adam Marks, my compadre in arms. Adam?
Yeah, and we've got a very exciting game today. We've got Macca Plumbing in brown versus Farmington Bank, who's wearing purple today. Both these teams finished the regular season 8-2, so it should be a very competitive game today.
I think it will. Let's see. One of these teams is coached by my son, Sam Gamo, first-year coach, and we really like to congratulate him and commend him for doing an excellent job for the first year. Okay, we had a medical checkup.
All right, so Macca moves the ball into the front court, swinging the ball around. And it looks like they will have the ball out under the basket.
Macca does an excellent job moving the ball offensively. And most kids move without the ball, is what we try to teach. As you can see, they go in and out. Rebound by Yao. Big man, Yao Kanadu.
And Luke Duzan moves the ball into the front court.
And C.J. Francois just gave up the ball. He does a fantastic job going baseline. I think one of the keys today, Adam, is that Macca needs to control C.J. from taking that baseline.
Yeah, absolutely. And you know, we're seeing another key right now. Macca's got to be able to beat Farmington Bank's press, which is a very aggressive press. So they're going to have to be able to beat that press, get good possessions.
And a three, little rush job. I think the nerves have both teams right now. They need to settle down.
Yeah, you see that in a lot of the games with the kids this age. You know, start out a little shaky, and eventually they get their legs under them.
And that was Tomas Persano, number 34, for Farmington Bank with the 2 points. Turnover by 23, Alex Sarkisian.
So we're about 2 minutes into the game here, and Farmington's leading 2-0.
We have an offensive foul by number 34 with a push-off.
Extended the arm a little bit there. Macca was in good defending position, and offensive foul.
Good defense by 42, Yao. A little quiet here in the house.
Farmington playing some good aggressive defense. Macca's having some tough little trouble looking for a shot. But, and that last shot by Alex Sarkisian blocked by Yao, the big man in the middle.
Big Yao, rejection.
He's a great defender down there for protecting the rim for Farmington Bank. He's been doing that all year.
Little raw offensively, but he can defend. And what a great 3-point shot by Felix from the 32.
Felix Lopez sinks the three to give Macca a 1-point lead, 3-2.
Luke Duzan with the ball. Good defensive 2-3 zone by Macca. Duzan's trying to penetrate, gives it up to Yao. Duzan with the three, and he hits.
And Farmington takes the lead back, 5-3.
Yeah, there is no issue for them with this press.
Yeah, they Macca's got a lot of good ball handlers, so they should be able to.
No, he's out of bounds. Brown's out of bounds. Brown was out of bounds. You.
So the call was that Eric Resto had his foot on the line when he touched the ball. Farmington gets possession.
Farmington swinging the ball. Out of bounds on Macca.
And we've got our first sub of the game. In for Farmington Bank is Johnny Robinson. And to the bench, Luke Duzan getting a little bit of a rest after a great start, including that three-pointer.
Johnny Robinson is from the famous football family of West Hartford, son of Frank Robinson, who is the head football coach here at Hall. Farmington swings the ball.
Farmington's doing a good job moving the ball around, but the Macca defense is getting into position and not giving them any lanes or open shots.
Tomas Persano with the ball. Looks like he's a big point guard.
Looks like they've called a play, trying to get the ball to CJ Francois.
Yeah, swings it. A little high for Johnny Robinson. We have subs.
In for Macca is Connor Lechna, and he looks to be replacing Spencer Martindale. And also in Seamus O'Connell for Eric Resto. Some good battles under the boards right there, and Tomas Persano comes down with the ball.
Playing a sort of aggressive 2-3 zone. Seems to be a matchup zone.
And a matchup zone is, your standard zone defense with some more man-to-man principles.
Number 32, Boomer.
And Macca moves the ball into the front court.
Very nicely. Alex Sarkisian with the ball. Gives it up to Evan Smart. Seamus shoots. He was looking for a foul here. Tomas Persano with the three, and he hits.
Good. Tomas yesterday in the semifinal victory over L&M Paving he had that shot going, and he was hitting a bunch of threes, aggressively driving to the rim, and it looks like that may have continued today.
Nice take by Evan Smart, number 33 for Macca Plumbing.
Yeah. Evan with a nice head fake got Yao off his feet and was able to maneuver around to score the basket, and it's now 8-5 Farmington with the three-point lead with about 2 minutes left in the
with the steal, and he goes up and gets fouled. We have an old-fashioned three-point play.
That's right. And we've got subs for Macca. It looks like coming in Jack Carrera.
Farmington Bank.
For Farmington Bank. Jack Correa, Charles Trunick, Dylan Romano, and Jack Coonley are all out there right now for Farmington Bank.
Rebound by number 3. Connor Olechna gets his own rebound. That's what we try to teach. Follow your shot. Olechna with the three, and he hits.
And he gives Macca the two-point lead, 10-8.
And Macca now is pressuring. Foul on number 34 for Macca, Seamus O'Connell.
And You'll see Farmington Bank has gone with a smaller lineup here right now. Macca's got a size advantage. We'll see if they can take advantage for the next minute and a half of this first quarter. Battle for a rebound underneath. And Farmington Bank was on the baseline with the ball. It'll be Macca ball under the basket. And coming in for Alex Sarkeesian is number two, Ethan Soler.
And we have a timeout by Farmington Bank.
And so we've got a minute and 12 seconds left in the first quarter with Macca, a 2-point lead, 10-8. And Farmington takes a 30-second timeout.
And we are back. Farmington Bank with the ball after the timeout. Trying to gather themselves with Macca's full court press. Macca is very aggressive on defense.
Yeah, they've extended this zone a little bit. It looks like they're trying to jump into a passing lane, and they do. Connor Alekna steals the ball, going full court. Misses the layup. Looked like there was a little contact there, but I guess not enough for the refs to think there was a foul.
We have a travel call.
We've got a turnover there on Farmington Bank, and Macca will have the ball with 39 seconds left in this first quarter.
I think they're looking for a last shot, or maybe not.
Seamus O'Connell tips the ball back. They get another look. He goes up with the ball. And we've got about 20 seconds left in the first quarter. We'll see if Farmington holds for the last shot. And Macca keeping that defense extended. Steals the ball back to Farmington, back to Macca. And now Connor Alekna streaking down the court for a layup.
Misses. 1 point.
That was a frantic couple of possessions there. You got shot goes up, and he hits it. A three-pointer at the buzzer for Macca Plumbing. That's number 32, Felix Lopez, and that gives Macca a 5-point lead, 13-8 after the first quarter.
Storming back with a flurry.
You know. We got Felix Lopez playing out there with a soft wrap on his wrist, but it doesn't seem to be affecting his play. He's hit two three-pointers in that first quarter.
You're right. He took off the cast this week, and he seems to be coming back strong.
You know, and yesterday in Macca's semifinal victory over Wooden Tap, Felix had a great game, made a couple of acrobatic layups.
Felix did, you know. I just want to mention that my buddy over here, Adam Marks, was the coach of Wooden Tap. So he should be sitting on the other bench, not here with me announcing. But, the better team prevailed.
I can't agree with you more there, Joe. Wooden Tap, my team, we didn't have our stuff yesterday. Macca came to play. They played tough, and they're definitely deserving to be here.
Jump ball.
So we've got a jump ball there. Number 25 for Macca, Jeremy Zedoff, had his hands on the ball, as well did Dylan Romano, I believe, number four for Farmington Bank. Also in for Farmington Bank for the first time, number 25, Rashil Yarabelli. the number 33, Caleb Wu, is also in for the first time for Macca, or for Farmington Bank, excuse me.
Guzan with the ball, heading down the court. And Seamus O'Connell with the rebound, but loses the ball to Duzan. And now Duzan loses the ball. Gives it up to Eric Restel. Eric Restel taking it down court. Being harassed by Duzan of Farmington Bank.
Macca is moving the ball well around the perimeter here. Looking for a good shot, setting some screens against this 2-3 zone for Farmington Bank.
Good pass to Zetoff, 25 with the ball, turns it over on a deflection.
So Duzan there, looks like a little contact, not enough for a foul, missed the layup. It was rebounded by Caleb Wu, who put it up, missed the shot, but we'll have two free throws here. First one was a little long. Looked good though. We'll see if he can take a little off the second one.
Bank shot, a little too strong.
Rebound by Seamus O'Connell and knocked out of bounds by Luke Duzan. Ball to Macca. Macca has still a 13-8 lead as they did at the end of the first period. No one has scored here in the second. Oh my goodness.
We have the first 4-point attempt of the game.
So that was for Macca, number 5, Matt Burnett. Drains the 3-pointer as he was fouled. I believe that foul was on number... It was on number 5, Luke Duzan, for Farmington Bank.
We missed the 4-point attempt.
So Macca has now doubled up Farmington 16-8 with 6 minutes left in the first half. Spencer Martindale back in for Macca. That's number 4. Shot goes up and it's rebounded by Matt Burnett. He's doing some great things out there between hitting that 3-pointer.
Zadoff with a 2-point layup. Farmington Bank, who is up by double digits. And Duzan blows by the defenders to lay it in for 2.
He just weaved right through there. It looked like Macca might have been celebrating that last play a little bit. Didn't get back on defense, set up that zone. And that can be trouble if you don't get that zone set up. But good ball movement by Macca. You know, Eric Resto is doing a great job distributing, finding his guys good spots to...
the ball.
Good spots for a shot.
We have a foul line. Looks like number 5 for Macca Plumbing, Matt Burnett. Matt Burnett has been the hero of the second quarter here.
He is doing some great things out there for Macca, and Caleb Wu back to the line, where he will have another shot. See if he can't cut into this 10-point lead for Macca. Rebound to Macca, and Spencer Martindale heads up court. Swings the ball cross court to Eric Resto, who cuts into the zone, gets a shot up, banks it in. And Macca is now up to... That was a nice shot by Eric Resto, the smallest player out there on the court, but he's not deterred, not scared to go in there.
We have Luke Duzan, who is doing all the right things. He's attacking the zone.
That's right. You know, if you can split those two defenders at the top of the 2-3 zone, everything opens right up for you. He's looking to get that ball into the middle and up on the rim.
Bit kind of short.
Duzan misses both shots. Wu gets the rebound, misses, and Martindale heads up. He was looking for the home run pass there to Eric Resto. Just a bit too much on it.
A little too much.
Yeah.
I heard the coaches telling them not to get 2 inches, slow things down.
It looks like in for Macca now, number 11, Jimmy Toom. He's working up top on that zone with Eric Resto. And it looks like number 3 for Macca, Connor Alekna, is getting ready to check back in at the next whistle.
Spencer Martindale with the rebound, throws the ball away.
Ooh, looked like Duzan was looking for the foul there and not necessarily taking the strong layup. Duzan again, a little long, and he, ball's on the ground. And it looks like we've got a head ball. Got a held ball possession to Macca. Connor Alekna, just in for Macca, takes the 3. It's a little short. Rebound out to Johnny Robinson for Farmington Bank. And we've got an offensive foul there, number 23 on Farmington Bank, CJ Francois, who has just checked back in. You know, Farmington Bank throughout the year has kept Francois on the bench for most of the second quarter. It looks like...
getting a little nervous today?
Yeah,
a little
nervous. They're down by 12. It looks like they're trying to generate a little offense, cut into Macca's lead.
A lot of anxiety today. It's championship.
That's right. And here comes Francois running down court for the layup, and he puts it in to cut the lead to 10. Macca now leads 22-20 with 3 minutes left in the second quarter. And it looks like number 34, Tomas Persano for Farmington Bank, also set to check back in.
Looks like we're getting substitutions left and right over here.
Francois with the missed layup, Alekna moving down court for Macca, and he hits it. And Macca is again up with that 12-point lead.
It's great when kids can go coast to coast.
Yeah. Connor grabbed that ball right under his own basket and took it all the way.
Looks like we're going to get substitution for Macca Plumbing. We have Alex Sarkeesian and Evan Smart.
Please
fine, young men.
That last shot by Francois rattled out. Macca moves the ball into the corner with Spencer Martindale, cross court. Moving the ball down to the baseline, and they're doing a great job swinging around. And looked like Connor got that foot down before the ball came down, and that's a travel on Macca. The ball will be back to Farmington Bank.
It's a common move that most kids make at this age. We get to put the ball to the floor.
That's right. These guys, they're playing so quick. They just get that foot down before the ball hits.
Trap in the corner by Macca, number 33.
It looks like the call there was a jump ball with possession to Farmington Bank. Johnny Robinson takes it out. Gets it to Tomas Persano in the corner. Just a little short on that 3.
Long rebound by Alex Sarkeesian. Gives it up to Alekna. Lays it in nicely.
Yeah, Connor Alekna is being very aggressive. Trying to get out a little bit in front of the Farmington Bank defense. And Macca now has a 14-point lead.
They are putting nice pressure on the ball.
Persano up top with the 3-pointer, a little short, and the ball is out of bounds to Macca. You know, it looks like Farmington Bank might be pressing a little bit here. They are not used to being down very often.
They're not, and they're rushing their shots. They're not moving as freely as they normally do. There's Alekna with the same move, but put the ball down this time. Sarkeesian just takes it in. A little short.
Rebound to Persano, who looks to move it up court. We've got 1 minute left in the first half here. It is 26-12.
We have a travel by Tomas. A little confusion. on what he wanted to do with the ball.
You know, Joe, I think part of this might be we've got a lineup out here for Farmington Bank that we haven't seen much this season.
Well, well said.
The
players
are not necessarily familiar with one another.
Right. We need to mention that their head coach is away for work, and assistant coach Carl Denson has taken over head coach duty. So he may be a little unfamiliar. Let's have a travel. Connor Olechna is rushing a little bit today.
Yep. Looked like he made the shot and made the move, didn't expect to find himself so open. Shuffled those feet a little bit before the shot came up. So we've got now 30 seconds left in the first half. Maca continues to lead 26-12 on Farmington Bank.
Persano with the ball. Trying to find somebody to swing it to.
We got 15 seconds left here. It looks like Farmington might be looking for the last shot. Persano moves it in. Tosses it to...
rebound Farmington. Persano with the ball again.
Gets it up.
And he hits the three.
Hits the buzzer beater just before the end of the first half. So we've got a 26-15 score. Maca with the lead by 11, and we've got halftime here. Coaches will look to make some adjustments.
I'm sure they will. You know, Farmington has been here before. They were down yesterday by 12 and managed to come back. So we'll see.
And, Maca was, down significantly to Farmington in their regular season game. Came back. It looks like there's some question on how many points that last shot was for, so we're double checking.
And we are back from our break.
So we've, once again, we've got a 26-15 game. Maca leads by 11 here. And out for Farmington Bank, it looks like they've brought back the starting lineup. Luke Duzan, Daquan Boomer, Tomas Persano, CJ Francois, and Yao Kanadu.
And for Mecca Plumbing, we have number 3, Connor Alekna, number 2, Ethan Solar, 23, Alex Sarkeesian, 25, Jeremy Zetoff, and 32, Felix Lopez.
Looks like Macca, or Farmington rather, is looking to trap. Macca does a great job getting a look there for Felix Lopez. Oh, and Alex Sarkeesian with a great steal. You know, Alex Sarkeesian, great move. He felt Yao coming behind him. He knew that he couldn't get that shot up. He stopped.
Relentless pursuit for that ball. He wanted that ball, and he created the turnover. Willis with the shot, 3-point attempt.
Oh, and it looks like Macca's thrown the ball away. Daquan Boomer with the shot, rebound. Eventually gets to Luke Duzan, who hits the 2-point shot. And looks like Macca's losing their composure just a little bit here. We'll see if they can get it back. Oh, it's Francois, looks like slipped on the floor a little bit. But Duzan slices through the zone for a 2-point shot.
We have a 30-second timeout called by Macca Plumbing.
Farmington starting the second half with a quick 4-0 run to bring the score to 26-19. Looks like Macca is just trying to get things back under control. You know, they played a very strong first half. And it looks like Sam Gamo is just trying to tell the kids to relax a little bit, you know. Keep doing what they're doing.
He's giving the players some assignments, tells who he wants with the ball, bringing it up, trying to control the team and have them relax a bit.
And ball back out to Macca. Farmington Bank in their classic press defense, which they've played virtually every game all season with great success.
Duzan with the steal. Sarkeesian comes up with it.
And the ball there, you know, Farmington, or Macca rather, looked a bit uncomfortable with the trap and turnover back to Farmington Bank. And Yao and Daquan are checking out for Farmington. Evan Smart is in for Macca, and in for Farmington, number 10, Jack Coonley. And it looks like number 11, Jack Correa.
Tomas Persada with the ball.
Alekna pokes it away. Ball will be Farmington possession. Good defense along the baseline by Evan Smart on Francois.
Duzan attacks the hoop again and score.
You know, Duzan is really cutting through this Macca zone.
23. Bottom.
We got
foul, number 23, CJ Francois.
Little block and foul along the sideline, cutting off Alekna's path.
Alekna with the ball, gives it up to Sarkeesian. Felix with the ball. We got a little travel, a little indecision.
It looks like number 32 for Macca, Felix Lopez. He couldn't decide if he wanted to shoot that corner three or make a drive for a pass. Alex Sarkeesian and Connor Alekna checking out for Macca in our Eric Resto and number 34, Seamus O'Connell.
A Eric Resta with the ball for Maca Plumbing.
Swings it to Smart, drives baseline. It looks like Perzano knocked it back. Boomer with the layup, misses it. Resto's on the ground. And Persano nearly lifts Resto up as he was holding on to that ball for dear life. That'll be a jump ball possession to Farmington.
Great effort by number one, Eric Resto.
That's right. He may not be the biggest kid on the court, but he plays with a lot of heart. And Persano with the three-pointer. The score is now 26-24.
And Smart misses that easy layup. Persano with the ball.
You know, Maca has not yet scored this half. Farmington has really picked up their defense.
They are struggling.
Persano with a nice drive. We saw him do that time and time again yesterday. Unfortunately, he just can't get the roll on the layup. And it's out of bounds to Farmington Bank. CJ Francois makes a move, misses a short jumper. Rebound to Farmington Bank. We've got a
substitution. 23 in for number Alex Sarkeesian, in for Ethan Solar.
Francois with the three, just rims out. And Duzan
with the putback.
You know, and we have a tie game here.
Number 11 with the foul, and a all tied up, 26 all.
In for Tomas Persano is Yao Konadu.
He got bailed out.
Yeah, it looked like Farmington might be able to get a 10-second call there, not being able to, or keeping Maca from advancing it across half court. But
okay, Eric Resta with the ball, gives it up to Evan Smart. Sarkeesian drives. And they just cannot buy a basket.
Great pass there along the baseline. I believe that was Eric Resto to Evan Smart. Evan Smart, though, with the double clutch on the layup. And that's the effect of Yao Konadu. You know, you see the big man there ready to block your shot, and everyone just feels the need to adjust what they're doing.
Adam, I'm noticing a lot of hesitation here on the part of Maca Plumbing. They look a little nervous. They're forcing everything. The pressure's on them.
CJ Francois with the move along the baseline, which he loves to go left along that baseline, just can't get the ball to drop. But we've got a tie game here. It's 20.
Maca is not pressuring the ball like they were in the first half. Travel.
You know, and that's what we were talking about in the first half. The guys at this age, they see the basket in front of them, and they just move a little too quick. But we've got about 3.5 minutes left in the third quarter. Maca moves the ball up court.
Nice job.
Great pass from Evan Smart to Seamus O'Connell for the layup. That's what can happen when you beat that press. You can get some fast breaks. A rebound by O'Connell out to Resto. Resto looks up. He sees Sarkeesian. Sarkeesian Sarkisian slows it down. We've got a push.
We have a push on number, I believe, 32, Felix Lopez.
And in for Macca is Spencer Martindale, replacing Seamus O'Connell, who gave Macca some great minutes here in the third quarter. 28 to 26, ball gets to Francois, loses it. Sarkisian down court, grabs it, makes a move on Farmington Bank. Ooh, and it looks like that was a held ball. Ball out to Farmington.
Farmington.
Francois.
We have Tomas.
Out to Persano. Persano around the back. Gets
CJ
the ball up.
With the rebound and put back. Oh. I believe that's 3-on-23. We have a substitution for CJ Francois.
Sarkisian
with the turnover.
A little too quick there. Ball bounces out. We've got a tie game here, 28-28. 2 minutes and 20 seconds left.
And Farmington Bank with the ball. Smart with the ball.
Ooh, looked like it could have been a travel there. The referees seemed to see it a little differently. And Farmington, I believe, has taken their first lead of the game, I believe. 30-28 with a minute and 52 seconds left in the third quarter. And Joe, it looks like Macca is losing their composure just a little bit.
They're falling apart at the seams. They need to regain their composure and start playing basketball.
You know, you thought maybe when CJ Francois picked up that third foul, sending him to the bench, that it might be a little advantage there for Macca, but it hasn't come to fruition.
Well said.
Martin
with the ball.
Moves up court. A good pass to Resto. That was a great job breaking the press. Smart with the ball.
Good ball movement now. Looks like they've changed. Little travel. Way too much indecision.
Sarkisian shuffles his feet there. Turnover to Farmington Bank.
Ball movement by Farmington Bank. He's trying to cut through. We have Martindale with the ball. Little out of control.
Persano passes it out to Daquan Boomer, gets it back on the baseline, a little long on the jumper, rebound to Sarkisian, and we've got a jump ball, Macca's possession.
Thank you.
Long pass. Boomer grabs it. Martindale with the rebound. He's moving back up court. A little floater over. Martindale with a great hustle play. Gets the, pokes the ball away from Duzan, then is able to throw it off him out of bounds. We've got some subs here. Tomas Persano getting a bit of a breather. In for Maka, Seamus O'Connell. Lopez drives baseline, looks for Sarkisian, it's poked away. We've got a timeout, 30 seconds to Maka. Looks like Sam Gamo is going to try to draw something up. There's 8 seconds left here in the third quarter, and it looks like Farmington has a 30-28 lead.
With 8 seconds remaining in the third.
It's been a very competitive game here. Both teams, you know, they've been playing well for periods, a little bit out of control at other times, but overall the team seemed pretty evenly matched. All right. Ball into Alekna with the 2-point shot. Misses. And the quarter ends. Farmington Bank with a 30-28 lead on Maka Plumbing with just 8 minutes left in the season for the senior division of the Western Youth Basketball League.
It was a flurry by Farmington Bank.
You know, and they've done that time and time again. They score in bunches.
They are used to it. This is what they do. Let's see what the adjustments Maka Plumbing does.
And we are back here in the fourth quarter. Farmington leading 30-28. Maka in their 2-3 zone. And it looks like for Farmington Bank, we've got CJ Francois is back into the game, as is Tomas Persano.
Luke Duzan's going back in.
For Johnny Robinson, it looks like. Quick substitution right there. I think coach might have thought Johnny would have a tough time inbounding it on the sideline.
Good call.
Great defense.
Good defense by Evan Smart, number 33 from Maka.
Spencer Martindale out there hustling.
Yes, he is. Good ball moving by Maka. Just no luck with the shot. A little short.
Ball out to Persano.
Takes a three. Airballs it.
He was a good 4 or 5 feet behind the 3-point line, but he.
Not a shot I would attempt.
Macca barely beats the press again. Lopez baseline, tries the up and under.
Those shots are not going to fall. That's just not good basketball. There he is with the baseline move.
That's Francois right there. Giving Farmington Bank a 4-point lead, 32-28. And we've got a jump ball there. Ball out to Macca underneath the basket. You know, a great defensive play by CJ Francois right there.
And we get the and one.
Martindale's first attempt was blocked, I believe, by Persano, but he persisted. He stuck with it. He grabbed the ball, got it back up on the rim, and gives Macca a chance to maybe be only down one here.
Lane violation by number 34.
Joe, I actually think he was over the back there. I think they called that a foul.
They called a foul.
And we've got a substitution for Farmington, number 10, Jack Coonley.
We had a equipment violation.
There was a little two-man game by Persano and Francois. They you know, it's a question of whether Macca really wanted that timeout there. You wanted to save the possession, but now they've only got one timeout left. In a close game, it's a 2-point lead for Farmington with 5:53 left. There's a lot of game time left.
A lot of game. It's a battle. And, you know, those timeouts are precious.
To contrast, Farmington Bank still has four timeouts. So if it gets tight there at the end, they'll have time to set their defense, put in a play.
Well said.
And Macca comes back out here, ready to go.
With the ball, with a full court press.
We've got a bit of confusion here. It looks like Farmington was trying to make a substitution, but their player did not check in, so the referees rightly did not allow it.
Turnover by Macca Plum and Evans.
And sub in number 11 for Macca, Jack Correa, in for number 10, Jack Coonley.
Jack for Jack.
There you go. CJ Francois swings it out to Persano. He actually looked like he thought for a second about pulling it there.
Swinging the ball nicely. He just go again. baseline.
Sounded like a lot of contact, but
tripping by number 34. We looks like 1-on-1 situation for Macca Plumbing.
Alex Sarkeesian checking in for Spencer Martindale. As Eric Resto goes for the line, 1-on-1.
Hits the first to make it a 32-31 game.
We have Connor Alekia going in for the shooter. And we're all tied up.
And we've got a tie game. Eric Resto hits both foul shots. It is 32-32 with 5 minutes and 15 seconds left in the fourth quarter.
You can feel the tension in the room, guys.
And Connor Alekna, who's been Macca's spark plug today, has checked back in. We'll see if he can give them that spark once more.
Looks like they're putting a little ball pressure. Good defensive rotation.
Rebound there out to Lopez, and I'll tell you what, he may be playing with one hand, but he's doing a heck of a job.
And we've got the lead by Macca Plumbing.
Great ball movement on that fast break.
Looks like Macca has regained their composure. You can take a look at the look on their face. Look at the intensity. They are playing smart ball. Good move by CJ.
You know, we've said a couple of times he loves that baseline.
Alekna
and
with the ball.
He has tied the game 34-34. With 4 minutes left.
Ball's out of bounds by Luke Duzan of Farmington Bank. Tomas Persino's coming back in for number 10, Jack Coonley. Good ball movement. Nice job relaxing. Moving the ball around. Good defense by Farmington Bank. And we have a little.
Oh, and O'Connell saves the ball. Too smart. Passes it to Sarkeesian, who puts up a shot with a good rebound by Francois, who advances the ball.
And we have a foul. A number 23, Alex Sarkeesian. Duzan with the ball.
Persano with the drive, gets his own rebound.
Puts up a three, and he nails a three.
He got quite a bit of height on that three-pointer. Ball to Macca, and it's a turnover to Farmington. Foul
on Felix Lopez, 32.
Macca is down 37-34, nearly a 5-point lead there for Farmington.
Turnover, Macca Plumbing.
Misses the layup, but Macca hurries down court a little too quickly, and the ball is back out to Farmington Bank, who has the 3-point lead with 2 minutes and 51
seconds to go. We have a ball out of bounds on Macca Plumbing.
you know, Macca has done a great job defending CJ Francois for the vast majority of the
they
game.
They are. But Luke Duzan has stepped up.
As has Tomas Persano, unfortunately a bit long for him on that three, but rebound out to Duzan.
Persano with the ball, gives it up to Daquan Boomer.
Short on that three.
Miss. Felix Lopez with the shot. I want to say it's a little rush shot. And
Alekno moves the ball up court. Finds Resto.
Turnover. Macca Plumbing with Farmington Bank has a 5-point lead.
It's 39-34, and we've got a minute and 35 seconds left in the fourth quarter. We'll see if Macca's going to put a little press on. It looks like they do. But Farmington beats it. Duzan with
Farmington
the layup.
Farmington Bank has taken a 6-point lead with a minute 20 seconds to go.
It's actually a 7-point lead, Joe.
7, sorry.
41-34. Lopez with the drive. He'll have two shots here. See if he can get it to a 5-point game.
Substitution number 3, Connor Alekna in for Seamus O'Connell.
One shot left here for Felix Lopez with a minute and 11 seconds left. And he cuts the lead to 6. We've got a 2-possession game here. We'll see if Macca can't force
some pressure on the ball. Gotta pressure the ball. And you get a steal.
Ball to Alekna, who pulls up for a three and hits it. It is a 1-possession game, 41-38. Farmington with the ball. Ball to Francois.
We have a timeout.
Farmington Bay gets a timeout. 3-point game with 37.3 seconds left. So we are back, 3-point game, 41-38. Daquan Boomer taking the ball out of bounds. Looking to get it into Duzan. Duzan gets it. Ball to Francois. Foul on Spencer Martindale. That's Macca's 6th team foul. The next one, Farmington Bank will be shooting 1-1.
And a timeout there to Macca. 41-38. 20.2 seconds left here. Farmington with a three-point lead and the ball.
And let's see what Farmington does. Let's see what offense they set up, because we know Macca Plum is going to come after them.
Absolutely. They're going to try to get a quick steal, and if they can't get a turnover, they're going to need to foul and see if they can't put someone on the line who might miss the front end of a one-and-one and that, give Macca a chance.
That's what they need to do.
Ball into Duzan. And Duzan, with 12.0 seconds left, will head to the line for one and one. And if he makes the first one, it's going to be some tough sledding for Macca.
Tough. It's really tough either way. I think, do they have one timeout?
Macca has one timeout left, yes.
He banks it.
Duzan a little long on the free throw, but it drops. Farmington Bank with a four-point lead, 12.7 seconds left. Second shot missed. Out to Spencer Martindale. Moves up court.
And he gets fouled.
He is fouled. We'll have a chance.
This is sometimes what you hope for. You want to make both and then pressure the ball.
So it is a four-point game here. Farmington 42, 238, 6.4 seconds left.
Oh.
Martindale misses the first. He's going to need to make this, and then Macca will have to foul, and again, hope that the one-and-one.
And looks like time is running out.
Yeah.
With Macca shooting free throws. We have Farmington Bank shooting free throws.
It's a four-point lead here for Farmington Bank, 42-38 with just 3.5 seconds left. Persano misses the first. Tapped out of bounds, but there's 1 point. There's 1.9 seconds left here. And Farmington Bank has won the championship 42-38.
Great job. Congratulations to Farmington Bank and to Ricardo Brown, who couldn't be here today, but Carl Denson and Ida Harris did an excellent job.